Hello, everybody. Today we're going to discuss a really interesting topic of web development. So for today is going to be Elasticsearch. We're going to discuss some basics and specifics of its work and how to integrate it properly with Node.js and some other things. So let's start. And actually, the very first question that I believe we need to resolve before we start is actually, why do we need this technology at all? There are lots of technologies. Why do we need exactly this one? So the main reason here is users are forever searching. Starting from the simplest landing page and ending with complicated CRM system, they want to search. Because nobody wants to waste their time just searching for content manually. Actually, that's why we have Google. So what does this mean for us, common web developers? It means that actually search functionality is one of the most important things in the entire application. So if your search is not responsive enough, a user will tell you for sure, I don't want to use your system, I'll just go to some other one where search will be responsive and fast. So we need to think carefully about search, we need to optimize it, and we need to be sure that it's fast enough for comfort usage. Actually, here you can tell me, oh, okay, I can just do select from my favorite SQL database and that's it. Of course, you can do it. You can do something like this using like operator, do some conditions between all the parameters that you want to have in your result data set. But there is one big problem. First of all, almost every SQL databases have small disclaimer inside their documentation about such operations, which will tell you, attention, this can be heavy operation, try to avoid usage of this one. Even NoSQL databases like MongoDB have such disclaimers. Another thing that you should take into account is join of data. So when you want to do some join operations, it can make your query even heavier. And if you just plus those two things, you'll see immediately that you have a problem with performance, especially when your data set is large or you need to query many parameters, like we have here in test client entry. Actually, those two problems are not new ones, and developers of SQL databases tried to resolve it by themselves, how they could do it. So some of databases like PostgreSQL that we're going to use for today, it provides like full text search native. You can try to use this one, but you'll understand immediately that it lacked just operators. So you can do substring search, for example. And actually that's not already serious enough. I mean, nobody wants to search starting from exactly the start of string. You just want to type something, see results, and that's it. And actually, it pushes us, and not only us, because many other developers try to resolve those three problems. First and second, I believe, in the first place. And the third one is kind of a problem for developers, because if you want to use, again, native things inside SQL database, you'll see problems immediately. And actually, trying to resolve those problems, they created something that is called Search Engine. Actually, Elasticsearch is search engine. Main purpose of this thing is formatting, storing, and retrieving of data. So yeah, that's simple. But with one small exception. When search engine creates something that is called search index, that set of formatted data, it uses some smart algorithms to optimize querying for this data. Just speeding up your queries for some data, it changes order, it can store it in different format, and etc, etc. I don't want to go too deep into such algorithms, you can just Google them if you're interested in. But the main thing here, that search engine actually shaped perfectly for searching your data. And it can do much faster search than you will ever do with native SQL, SQL instrumentary. But actually, the solution, well, it seems to be perfect, but to use it properly, in the first place, you need to know your data, and on the second one, you need to know your queries. So what I'm trying to say here, it is not required, and I believe even forbidden, to store everything that you have inside Search Index. So for example, even here you can see the difference. I have this set of data inside, but I query only for some subset from one entry, like for 6 properties instead of 8. And in reality, this subset that you query for, it can be even smaller, like 2 or 3 properties from the entire entry to search for. And you need to know very well needs of your new user. You need to plan it before you start to create search index, otherwise you will fail. Because again, no magic, of course, you have smart algorithms, they speed things up, but they can speed things up just to store like entry with 20 properties and be efficient enough. You need to plan everything accordingly. As for any other technical solutions, you need to know your data, need to know your queries, plan everything accordingly before you start. So again, before we start with some live example, I want to underline our stack for today. So it's going to be Node.js, PostgreSQL, Elasticsearch search engine, and Angular on front-end side. So, and actually our components, what we're going to use and how they interact with each other. So everything starts with front-end request to our API. Like a user wants to search for customers, actually customers that have the same data schema as we used for explanation before. And actually, let's see what happens for real with the data. So here I have data grid with those entries, actually well, designed in minimalistic manner, but anyways. I have around 200 pages, so I have 10,000 entries here, 50 for each page. So as you can see, we have pretty large data set to search for. And for example, I want to search for some specific entry like 1, 2, 3, 4. Actually, I should have it somewhere inside account names because I iterated exactly this one. So, and as you can see, data comes immediately, just immediately. So request is super fast. And if you open developer console and check the request, you'll find exactly the same. same schema that we used in our chart. So what happened here? I send a request with our search criteria. That's how it's going to work on your client side. So the only thing that you need to provide for the server, relevant REST API endpoint and some search query for searching, and that's it. So let's go back to our chart. What happens on API side, by the way? So, on the first place, API requests Elasticsearch server with your query. And Elasticsearch server returns you array of IDs, like unique identifiers for all the entries that it found. And after, you can use it just for querying the data from PostgreSQL. So, no search actions, no substring, nothing is required from your actual database. So, responsibility for searching fully goes to Elasticsearch server. Your database is just responsible for data storage and getting them back to you, and that's it. The thing that I want to underline here as well, as you can see the port here is a bit exotic, like 9200. Actually, that's a standard port for Elasticsearch, so if you just install it, your server will be up immediately and you can start to use it for indexing and searching. So let's tell about our workflow. Actually, it's related to data processing. So what happens with data processing? Normally, client wants to do a few things with the data, as you obviously know. So it can request for create, update, or delete of entry. Actually, read operation, we already discussed it. So our CRUD is not full here, but nevertheless. And what happens here? As you can see, we want to operations with data 2 times. I want to underline it, 2 times, not 1. Because first of all, you want to store something inside your database, like PostgreSQL, kind of straightforward. But in other hand, you want to store your search index to search for the data. And actually, one more time, I want to underline it, you have data duplication. And actually, that's the only way how search indexing can work. You provided some data, it stores it separately, it optimizes searching for these data chunks, and after you retrieve the data from the database. That's how it works. And actually, it can sound a bit frustrating and complicated because all approaches with relational databases, well, they tell us directly duplication of the data is bad. Well, not really nowadays, because, well, disk space is not so expensive as it used to be, and it's not bad when you store some duplicates to increase performance of your application. It's kind of widely used practice, so for us, that's the only way here. You store duplicates of this data here. The main question now, how to make this approach be easy enough and extendable enough, and not lose like connection between those two type of data. Well, at least, because if you have data inconsistency, you can have some problems, like you store index in Elasticsearch, but there is no related ID inside Postgres for this data, and in opposite way, it works the same. So it can break the logic of application. And actually, we can just provide some middleware. So what I'm trying to say here, in a common way, API just tells your database server, Postgres in our case, create, update, or delete entry with SQL query, and that's it. But in our case, a really good approach would be usage of ORM, so object model for our tables, not usage SQL immediately from your endpoint. Of course you can. Of course, if we go to the code and find our endpoint inside rows, so you can see it just here. I have only get request because I don't create anything in application, but you can have just post request next to it and in the first place send SQL query to database for entry creation, and after you can just send another query to search engine and create index there. Of course you can, but we're talking about extendable code which can be actually extended with extra properties or extra data easily without rewriting many things. That's why I would like to recommend you usage of ORM for PostgreSQL. There is a great ORM, it's called SQLize, so you can try this one. And basically, what does this mean for us in the matter of the code? Let's look into the model. Actually, model, small tutorial for the guys who are not familiar with ORM. Model is just an object representation of a table. So easy. Basically, it represents entry inside of a table, and it provides you many methods to interact with your data, like creation of entries, deletion of entries, update, and some other functionality. The thing that we want to do here, we want to extend functionality that ORM provides to us. So in the first place, we want to store some config for our model. For example, we have model customers, and we want to index only few of our properties in the data, like account name, city, and country. We don't want to store everything. Actually, that's a golden rule of search indexing that I actually told you before. So you don't want to store everything. You want to store only the things that you are going to search for. So in the first place, we want to extend this model representation for our data with some configuration for Elasticsearch. I believe it's quite understandable. The second thing, and I would tell even the trick, before we tell our main code part, like to API, that operation is done, before we do it, actually, we need to do one extra action, kind of extension. So how it's going to work? User requests an update from API or create or delete. You tell to ORM because it's now an interface for our SQL database. It, in the first place, sends a command to SQL database with appropriate query to create something or update something or delete or whatever. And somewhere between end of this operation and before we tell API that everything is done and you can notify user that everything is okay, we need to inject one more action that will go inside Elasticsearch and create appropriate index for us. And actually, that's true for any operation that we want to do. Like, whenever we want to create, update, or delete entry, we will just do this extra operation. So let's look into the code example how it can be done. Actually, some of databases we already have such functionality. ORMs for databases like Mongoose ORM. It has special plugin. It's Mongoose Elastic, and actually it provides set of decorators for models, and they do exactly this thing. So, what's going to happen here? Here, we just take options for our indexing. I said you before, why do we need them? After this, we're going to say original operation, so original method that sends all the details and does all the magic with SQL database. And after, we're going to override our original create method with extra action. So, what's going to happen here? In the first place, we do common action, original create, we create entry. After the entry is created, we're going to take all the required data from this entry and simply index it inside Elasticsearch and send exactly the same status that our ORM would send to API. And that's it. And actually, you can override any of actions in this manner. And that's it. So all of your models will auto-index every data that goes through them. So that's why I call that middleware, because it sits just between actual request and database and just mirrors all the data. And you can do the same with search requests. So you can extend model with search functionality as well, like send search. And it will just send search to your search engine, and after it will filter results from the database for you. And that's it. So, one more time, how a process goes. User requests something from API, you request it from ORM. ORM is extended with mirroring the data into the Elasticsearch server. First of all, you save data into common data storage, after you save it here. And it's true for any operation that changes the data. So the last thing for today that I want to tell for you guys is, that's basically about silver bullets. So there are no silver bullets in development, as you obviously know. And if you see that Elasticsearch just doesn't work as you want it to work, or your search queries just, it can be kind of primitive, like you search only for one parameter and only in one model, and it means it's not a reason to integrate one more technology. If search in your case can be done like with some other ways, like on client only, if you have just a really small set of search results, just get rid of Elasticsearch server and do it on client side, for example. It can be true for a landing page where you have just a really small piece of content. You can just return it as an object and filter it there, if you see that it won't high-load the traffic. But if you have a large set of entries that you need to search through, welcome Elasticsearch on board and try it. So thanks for attention. All the links for code sample and some other materials can be found under this video. If you have any question for me, please ask me and we can discuss it and I believe resolve it. So thanks for your attention one more time, guys. See you. Bye-bye.